unless you are failing, which is the case for most of us, especially if you're in the autistic community, because it's really hard to monetize your work in this free culture movement. Screw you, Jay-Z, your song is inaccurate. Yeah, man. But now I live in D.C. Oh, the people in D.C. are the worst. A lot of people with, like, jobs they feel morally ambiguous about. They're like, well, sure, I'm a lobbyist for Monsanto, but I'm putting my kids through college. I can sleep now. Oh, I can sleep at night somehow. Bullshit. And everybody's very guarded with their political opinions. Like, nobody wants to reveal how they feel about any situation, right? So, like, one thing I'll do in D.C. for, like, when I'm doing shows for crowds, like, D.C. crowds, I'll go like this. I'll go, like, round of applause if you think Edward Snowden is a hero, right? Like, that's what I'll do. Yeah, I figured that would be the response in this crowd, you know what I mean? All of our civil liberties. I think you guys know how I feel about it as well. But I'll ask this in D.C. to a D.C. crowd. I'll go, round of applause. You think Edward Snowden's a hero? I'll get this little trickle of applause like, oh, God. Why? Why am I doing this? No. This is my nightmare. This is my nightmare. This is my hell. And then I'll go, round of applause. You think he's a traitor? And then again, it'll be this little trickle like, oh, God. I don't want to be here with this. I don't want to know. And then I say this. Then I go, round of applause if you didn't applaud because you're maneuvering for a political position and you're not sure who's around. So you don't want to reveal how you feel about the situation. And I swear to God, everybody in the crowd is like, yeah! That's me! Yeah! I'm the third category! Yeah! I identify with that one! Yeah! My moral compass is broken! My moral compass is broken, but I don't care because I seek power! Hey, I want power! I want to be a congressional staffer! I want to be a congressional staffer! I want to work for Mitch McConnell! I want to work for Mitch McConnell! I want to work for a turtle-faced man! With a jolly gullet! With a jolly gullet! And if I do a good job, maybe he'll piss on me! World about Islam state and reach Buddhahood if it's just me and you. I'm gonna have to keep doing weird butt stuff with Tina on the side. That's just the rules, because I wanna be a good Buddhist, you know? I'm trying to reach Nirvana. I just wanna get to Nirvana. As you are, as you were, as I want you to be, as a friend, as a friend, as a little. I kind of want to, you know? Comedians want to be musicians in front of your rock stars, you know? It's cool. I have bipolar disorder. It's cool. I love that people clap. We know. We buy that, you know? Hey, man, Kurt Cobain also had bipolar disorder. I don't know if that's true, but I've been saying it a lot because it sounds cool, you know what I mean? That makes me sound cooler. If Kurt had it, yeah, I don't know, maybe he did. Why the fuck not? Right? It's weird, I've had to deal with a lot of weird stuff with it. It's like I have bipolar 1 disorder, which is also, it's like more manias, and then the depression is also known as classic bipolar. Classic bipolar, man, classic. My mental illness is like the Beatles' White Album, but like some places. Classic. And, you know, I've been on and off a bunch of antipsychotics and mood stabilizers over the years. Ladies. Pretty cool. Pretty chill. One of the weirdest ones I was on for a little while was called Sapris. Okay. I've done that joke before. I've never had anybody clap for Sapris. I'm about to tell you how fucked up of a medication it is. The fucking Big Pharma Zafras lobby has sucked into the Redacted Tonight show. Trying to push Zafras, the antipsychotic. No! No! It was a weird one, dude. And I'll tell you why, okay? It wasn't weird so much because of, like, the nightmares. Even though it was the induced nightmares, guys. What the fuck is that? Okay, whatever. It wasn't so much the nightmares or, like, the tricky boner situation, you know? The real tricky boner situation. Like, come on, man! Okay, you know? It wasn't so much the nightmares or the bone sitch, you know? It was weird from the way it was marketed on the box. This is real. This is what it said. It said, Zafras, black cherry flavor, sublingual, atypical antipsychotic. Oh, yummy! Oh, delish! Finally, a black cherry flavor. We hope if you take this, you'll stop going crazy, Bill. Sounds so good in my tummy tums. Wait a minute. Any chance you got that shit in blue raspberry? Or cookies and cream? Come on! Help a brother out! I'm seeing dead people over here! What's that now? Side effects include flavor overload! Oh no, not flavor overload! It's too delicious! I can't handle it! Kool-Aid guy burst through the walls. Take your pills, psychopath! Why are you into Zafras, dude? All right. I think I'm just gonna leave that a mystery. Stuff like that. So I got like, you know, I have all these different fans and stuff. So this is like an email from a fan, whatever, no big deal. Come on. It's from Haley, she's in college. She's a big fan of mine. This is real. From Haley. Hi, John. I stumbled upon your work through my abnormal psych class. Yes! This is real. And now I basically want to give my professor a giant hug because I'm so happy he inadvertently helped me find my favorite comedian. That's you, Wink. Thank you. I never felt so encouraged and horrified at the same exact moment in my entire life. And then she goes on to say, she goes, really though, thank you. I never thought I'd be able to laugh at mania or psychosis rather than cry or get angry. I hope you read this and find a sense of satisfaction knowing you've made a positive difference in my experience with this fucking annoying as shit disorder. And that means a lot to me, you know? Like, of course it does. That's awesome. Yeah. Thank you. But that being said, you guys, my stand-up comedy is being used as a pathological case study. In an abnormal psych class at a college. I don't know how to make sense out of that, you know? But more so, I really want to know what college. So I emailed her back. I did. And I said, Haley, thank you so much for sending me such a beautiful message. And I'm so happy that my comedy has connected with you. Also, I gotta know, how did you find out about me from your abnormal psych class? Is there like a professor showing clips of my stand-up or whatevs? I'd be honored if that were the case, haha. To which she did not reply. So I let 2 weeks pass, and I sent her another email. A follow-up. Johnny needs to know! Johnny needs to know! And this time I said, hey, Haley, like too many Y's, like H-E-Y-Y-Y-Y. Hey, too many Y's in that shit. Hey, Haley, I'm just really curious about where my stand-up's being shown at college. It's kind of an exciting thing for me. What class is it? And this time she got back to me, and she replied, she goes, hi, John, I was so excited to hear from you, but I must have let the message get buried in my inbox. Yes, my professor incorporated your comedy into a lecture. The course was Psych 405, Abnormal Psychology. Yes, son, Psych 405, kid. Upper level shit, at best. of my mental illness cannot be disrespected by being studied in no intro to psych 101 freshman year prerequisite bullshit. Nah, my psychosis can only be studied by students who have made a decision to concentrate in the major. Observe comedian John F. Hodano, the embodiment of insanity. On stage in his natural environment. See how he rants and raves about all the medications he's been on over the years to vaguely maintain a sense of ability to exist in society. Look at how he clings to his high-energy comedic persona, hoping against hope that he can evoke laughter loud enough out of strangers that will temporarily silence the madness lurking inside his person's soul. Through this sad clown, student. Through this sad clown. I mean, I don't know if that's how he does it for sure. You know what I mean? I'm just speculating. it's weird living in D.C., man. You know, like, because we've got all these really weird laws that get passed, but they have, like, positive-sounding names, but they do really negative things. Like a very Orwellian situation, you know? Like, a couple years ago, they passed the USA Freedom Act. Sounds pretty good to me, you know? USA Freedom? That's what we're all about. Sign me up, right? But it's bullshit. It's supposed to reform NSA surveillance, but it actually increases it, right? And then a lot of state levels, they're passing a lot of these right-to-work laws, which sounds good. It's like, if I want the right to work, I'm gonna fucking work, America, fuck yeah, you know what I mean? But people think it's actually the right to work for less because it undermines unions. So I think to balance things out, we gotta pass some laws that do positive things, but just have some really like negative-sounding names, you know? So there's a couple that I'm working on, maybe you guys have heard of them. Have you guys heard of the Darkness Shall Descend Upon America Act? It's in the works. The Darkness Shall Descend Upon America Act. I'll tell you what that does. That funds Head Start programs for at-risk children economically challenged neighborhoods. Darkness Shall Descend Upon America. Then another one I'm working on is trying to make its way through the Senate. Yeah, the Mandatory Pedophilia Act. Have you guys heard of that one yet? Mandatory Pedophilia Act. That diverts money away from military contracts and instead invests in infrastructure and green drops to put millions of Americans to work. Very cool. I want you guys all to know that you clap your cheers for the Mandatory Pedophilia Act. I want you to know you just did that. Joyfully in your hearts, you did that. And then there's one more. There's the path of the righteous man is beset on all sides by the inequity of the selfish and the tyranny of evil men. Blessed is he who, in the name of charity and goodwill, shepherds the weak through the valley of darkness, for he is truly his brother's keeper and the finder of lost children. And I will strike down upon thee with great vengeance and furious anger all those who would attempt to poison and destroy my brothers. And you will know my name is the Lord when I lay my vengeance upon thee. Pop, 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 hat. And that one for world peace, you guys. That one for world peace, yeah. That shit was from Paul Fiction, yeah. Hey guys, I'm John Goodall. That's all for me. Are you ready for your headliner of the evening?
Stop on there, everybody! Christmas! How are you guys? You good? It's a cool vibe in here. It's good to be back in New York. This is great. I've never been in this room. This is... I hope you're ready for my drum solo later. I'm getting ready. That's my closure. I'm gonna rip this off. And under there is David Blaine. It's gonna be fucking incredible. good to be here. So I'm gonna do we're gonna get into some issues.
Yeah.
That the country's having. And in light of that, I'm gonna do something a little bit different than I normally do at my shows. The first 45 minutes, we're just gonna all pair off and hug and cry, all right? Just be hugging and crying, so just getting two lines. And I feel like you guys would still leave, like, hey, that was a pretty good show, I fucking needed that. I thought I would get old, but no. But Trump's America, I gotta be honest, I feel freer, I do. Because here's the thing, I could come up here and my whole show could be, I could literally just drop my pants and just take a dump on the stage. And that wouldn't be the craziest thing you saw this week. News, I had to redo the math, and we're borderline light enough, so we're gonna go for it. Borderline light enough. We get 1,000 feet in the air, he's like, bad news, folks. We were borderline too heavy. But in Trump's America, they're like, you know what, let's go down, it's fine. Let the privacy invasion go, and this goes for all of our society, before we fucking get angry about it.
Yeah.
It's like, what level is too much, you know? Because you know, right? You know where that goes. It's like, hey, we just need you to take your shoes off, no big deal. Hey, we just need you to take your belt off, no big deal. Hey, we just need to take naked photos of you, no big deal. Hey, we just need you to call us Big Papa, no big deal. Every time. Hey, I paid my way through school. But so I opt out of that thing. And the reason is not because I think the machines are dangerous. They might be. I don't know if they say they're not. I don't know if they fucking are, because they always say something's not dangerous until it is. Until it's, you know, like Roundup herbicide. They're like, it's fine, until people start pumping out three-eyed babies. And then they're like, it's not as fine. Great vision. They can lose an eye and they're still good. They're still good. So I always I opt out of the machine. And the reason is, again, not because I think they're dangerous. The reason, and I've thought this out over thousands of flights, the reason is because fuck them. Alright? Fuck them. Do to make their job a little harder, to fucking jam up that line, cause some dude to waddle over to me in his too tight uniform and give me a half a hand job. Sure, why not? I'll be gay for the stay, I don't care, alright? Look, I'm heterosexual, but when it's 8 a.m. at an airport in Flagstaff, Arizona, sure give me a half a handy. Let's go for it. There's nothing else to do in this godforsaken town. I realized over again, thousands of flights, there's three types of pat-downs at airport security. There's three types, all right? The first one, the one you usually get, is the guy who's just, he's just done it 1,000 times, just wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, he doesn't grab you that hard, you don't understand the emails, it's all cool. Because he's doing a calculation, he didn't grab you that hard because he's doing a calculation in his head. He's like, you know what? Even if some terrorist gets through with some, you know, dick cannon or whatever he's got strapped on there, which isn't gonna happen because more people die from slipping in the tub, all right? But yes. But even if some guy gets by, it was worth it. It was worth it to not grab 200,000 flaccid airport cocks. You know what? They're not paying me enough. They're not paying me enough. It was worth it. So that's first. guy, the second guy is the worst one. It's the fucking Marine, usually like literally ex-Marine, is just like fucking grabs me like a goddamn dominatrix, you know? Afterwards, I'm like alone and confused. I got my shirt in my hand for some reason. My hair's messed up. I just want warm milk and a hug. Pretty sure I'm pregnant. It's not good. But I did figure out how to deal with those guys pretty early on. Right when I realized which path we're going down, you just start slowly moaning. It's like, oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Little bit of this, little bit of that. Go around them. Freedom! Like, they just lose their mind. You know what? Freedom! And what, they can do anything other than guys of freedom. Like, we gotta build a wall to have freedom. All right! Build that wall. I gotta get in this cave for freedom? Okay, absolutely. Just tie my hands up, I want to be extra free. We just want freedom, but we don't really have freedom, we have competitive freedom. We have freedom where you're free to step on your neighbor's throat to get a fucking extra dollar. That's the freedom we have. And the wealthier you are in our society, the freer you are. Alright, that's just a fact. Everything from fucking speeding tickets and parking tickets to criminal justice to the largest financial fraud this country's ever seen, they're free to do. You know, speeding tickets should be a proportion of your wealth. You know, so if a fucking billionaire wants to go 90 miles an hour, then he owes $1 million speeding ticket. There you go. Because otherwise, it's meaningless to them. But, you know, the wealthier you are, the freer you are. And you're freer to stay healthier because you can afford healthier foods. You can afford the best medicine. People, they just came out with a study recently. People that are wealthier live like 15 years more. You're literally buying more years on your life in this system. And, you're free to raise your kids in the best schools and get them the best education and give them daycare. If you're truly poor, you can't afford daycare. You just give your kid to, like, your crazy uncle, you know? A thousand-yard stare, and the kid wanders into some tentacle porn collection when he's, like, 6 years old, and he's never the same. He's never the same after that. He marries a squid when he's 18. He never got his shit right up there. Literally, the freer you are. Even with, like, the fact that... You know, they make a big deal of how, these people are joining the military to go to college. Isn't that great? No, if you're willing to kill or possibly be killed in order to go to college, that means college is too expensive. About it in those terms. Like when the kid comes in, he's like, so, you're willing to kill someone to go to college? All right, his name is Carl, he'll be here in a minute. Once you strangle him out, it is Penn State, here we come. And our media just celebrates it. Do you remember the night when Trump bombed Syria? It was, in our media, mainstream media, it was like it was a quinceañera. They were just fucking celebrating. Brian Williams jizzed all over his desk. They had to send a kid in to mop off his desk. It's a fucking mess. Jesus Christ. They're so excited. They're like, this is our advanced weaponry. Look at how advanced our weaponry is. There's nothing advanced about bombing somebody, all right? That would be like if you were watching a pool tournament and all of a sudden one of the guys took his pool stick and just broke it over the back of the guy next to him. And they're like, wow, that was an advanced move. That was really advanced technique here. All this fucking euphemism terminology, it's collateral damage, it's It's the secondary unintended targets. It came out that 9, this is a couple of years ago, they showed, these are the Pentagon's own fucking numbers, that 90% of drone bombings were killing innocent people. 90% were innocent, unintended targets. Which, here's the thing, if it's not intended, it's not a fucking target, is it? All right? It's not a target. Except that the drone bombing program is creating more terrorists than it kills. Which means, basically, we treat terrorism like it's a dandelion. We go, I really hate this. Now it's gone. But people are waking up to this shit, though. That's what I'm excited about. That's my optimism. Something like 6% of people still have full faith in the mainstream media. Many of them are eating crayons, so it's... People are waking up, and you see this change. I mean, it really has a lot to do with the information revolution, which is why, of course, we need to keep a free and open internet. But you've seen this over the past, like, 20 years. Like, people don't, but, like, over the past 20 years, marijuana went from, like, 90% disapproval to, like, 6% disapproval or something. And gay marriage went from, like, 80% down to, like, 10%. And you see, like, people just don't believe that pot's gonna rot your brain and it's gonna turn your kids into zombies to try and kill you in your sleep, you know? And people don't believe that gay people are gonna rot your brain and turn your kids into zombies that are gonna blow you in your sleep, you know? All this fucking bullshit media, and they're just selling us shit. I saw an article that I felt, I saw an article that I felt really showed this. It was an article, the title of the article was, 14 healthiest items at fast food restaurants. That's a news article. 14 healthiest items at a fast food restaurant. I was like, what is it gonna say? The chairs? The napkins? Looks like the woman at Macy's who sprays perfume in your face when you walk in. Like, oh God, I just threw for some socks, you know? Is this illegal by the Geneva Convention? But she is gutting public schools. By the way, she had never stepped foot in a public school in her life before she took over the public schools, which is, you know, that's par for the course under the Trump presidency. You know, he's got the guy who hates the EPA in charge of the EPA, and he's got the head of ExxonMobil in charge of the State Department, the guy who hates the Energy Department in charge of energy, he's got the brain surgeon in charge of housing and urban development. But the beauty of that is it is taking the facade off of our system, all right? You can see clearly now, in late-stage capitalism, the corporations take control of the state, and until now, it's been happening, but until now, you didn't point and go, that's the CEO of ExxonMobil. Trump is literally a brand name, all right? So. The guys has come off, you know, and I think that maybe is important for people to wake up. But yeah, they're defunding public schools, which sucks, because they already defunded public schools so much that, like, the fucking cafeteria lady's also the biology teacher, you know. She's gotta use the same ice cream scoop for both. This country used to want smart people. We used to, back as, like, the 50s and stuff, they wanted smart people because we were competing with other countries. And they're like, we make everyone smart, we'll beat those other countries. But now, they're multinational corporations. They don't give a fuck about a country, all right? They want dumb people they can easily govern. So, you know, they realized what was going wrong in about the 60s, you know? about the 60s, people started talking about peace and putting their tits out there, and all of a sudden they were like, we gotta change this shit. People are getting too educated. Too educated. That, you know, because dumb people are great. Dumb people are beautiful for a democracy, you know? Dumb people are, because they just get in line. They don't even know what the line's for. They're like, it's the line, all right, yeah, it's the line. Lines for jobs. They just say jobs. Doesn't even matter what the fuck it's for, just jobs. Jobs putting oil pipelines in, you know. They're like, okay, oil pipes too. I get a job. Can I buy a pizza with my job money? You know, that's the extent of the question. Smart people are awful for that. Smart people ask questions. Smart people are like, jobs doing what? Jobs cleaning oil out of our water? Jobs windexing an owl? How fucking. Just to make you a little richer so you can buy a yacht to put your other yacht inside of? You know, to house your prostitutes that sometimes go inside your other prostitutes?
You know, they just say jobs! Everyone's so excited. So excited.
They're like, well, we need the oil for energy. Here, I got an idea. How about, instead of fucking oil, we power the country with people on stationary bikes? There's a job, all right? Everybody's fucking skinny, looking tight, great ass. Doesn't even need to be stationary bike. Could be any one of those workout equipment, you know? Just, what is that, the vagina spreader, whatever that thing is, you know? The shake weights, you know? How are we gonna do the shake weights? We're all, men are all doing this, buddy, whatever we got. Strong forearms. There you go, I solved the job crisis, the energy crisis, and climate change in one sentence. I mean, the other thing is we should all be preparing for a rather jobless society where you do what you actually want to do with your life.
Yeah.
Instead, we're all scrambling. And you know, basically, it's like we're all hamsters on treadmills, and we're just fucking running our hearts out, and they're slowly taking away the treadmills, right? More and more becoming automated, and so like, oh, this treadmill's gone, that treadmill's gone, and so all the hamsters slowly start crowding on more, fewer and fewer treadmills. We're just tackling each other, punching the fuck out of our hamsters, get my treadmill. And then politicians come up and they say, I will bring back the treadmills! And then another one says, I will make the treadmills faster! So you get paid more on the treadmill! And no one says, why are we on the treadmills? We have to be educated to see through all this shit. Because, you know, I'm not a parent, but I think very few parents teach their kids how to see through the bullshit. You know, a lot of school is designed to teach kids to toe the line, to teach them to, you write down Christopher Columbus was a hero, alright? If you write he wasn't, you get an F, because you put the wrong fake answer. You know, you gotta see through this shit. We live in a massive lie. I mean, you know, like things like the free market monetary system that is,
yeah.
that does not reward sustainability or abundance in any way whatsoever, so it just has to create scarcity and insecurity.
Yeah.
That's all it does. So we live in like a massive lie, but there's also a lot of little lies, and I feel like they're important because if you see through those, it opens, for a lot of people, it opens everything else up. You know, the number of people I've talked to where, like, they started looking into their health care and realizing that their doctor wasn't really giving them the right information, and that they found that odd, and then they started reading other stuff, and then everything unravels, you know? And I'm not saying doctors suck. Doctors are wonderful. But I think you have to learn to ask questions. And you know, so there's a lot of little lies. Like I'm going to go through a few of them. Like, expiration dates on food. They don't mean anything. They don't fucking mean anything. But we throw out so much food, we throw out 40% of our food. A lot of it because of expiration dates. You know, people, you can't even donate most of that to homeless shelters because it's past the expiration date. There's like three things that expiration dates actually matter. It's like open deli meats, unpasteurized cheese, and like Norwegian ass or something. I don't know. There's like three things.
I've never
where it actually matters. Some of them say best if enjoyed by.
The illusion of control, that's all it is. We love the illusion of control, we do.
Hence voting. Such numbers that we swamp what's stolen. You know? You have to beat up the amount that's stolen. It is amazing. It blows my mind that we're okay with our current voting system, our current election system. Because most of it, the people in this room aren't okay with it. I have bad news for you. There's a couple of people outside that are fucking fine with it.
It's proprietary code. You can't see what's going on. You cannot check whether you're getting a legitimate result. It is a complete black box voting system, and we seem fine with it. Now imagine if the last 10 minutes of the Super Bowl was they just sent the crowds home, they pulled the curtain, they turned off the cameras, and then 10 minutes later a ref came out and it was like, Cowboys won.
Everywhere. It would be the end of the world. Fuck the Super Bowl. How about Little League? If they did that on Little League games, the parents would have the umpire's head on a spike. And they're like, well, we thought it might help, but we didn't know. If you don't know, don't you err on the side of not telling everybody to tongue blast a corpse? You fucking assholes. Hey, if your friend keels over, stick your dick in his ear. Could work. If anything's gonna wake up the dead, it's a dick in the ear. Although if it works, you don't have a friend anymore. Percentage of people, 85 individuals now have the same amount of wealth as the bottom half of the world. The bottom half of the world. And then here's the other thing is when you have that fucking much wealth at the top, it's unstable too. It's not fucking stable. It's, you know how our economy's set up? Just picture Chris Christie riding on the shoulders of Natalie Portman. That's our economy. Doesn't last long. The jobs are going away. They are. Self-driving cars are just about here. And transportation is a major employer in this country. They already have self-driving Uber, I guess they're doing it in Pittsburgh. And here's the thing. That raises a lot of questions for our society, and we just ignore them. We don't answer. The most important one being, when you pass one of those self-driving cars, who do you yell at to eat a bag of dicks? What are you gonna yell at the algorithm? You got it. And then I'm sure it would have some sort of insult algorithm so it fucking nails you right back perfectly. Like, eat a bag of dicks! Your dad loves your brothers better. And yet they still dance out there and they're like, here's the weather. The weatherman dates back to a time when there were three channels. And he was the only one on the planet with the information. We would turn on the TV, oh, tell us, prophet. What will fall from the heavens today? You're our only hope. Now it's on our phones and we're still trotting them out there.
They're not even doing it in an interesting way. They should be fucking spinning plates and shit. Fucking earning their keep. You give a fuck if you kill a black person. Only white people matter, yeah. Great, so you kill Gary Busey, it's a real loss, you know? But that really dates back to the Wild West. When, you know, when people lived to like 20 years old. So if you killed them, you were taking like 2 years from them. You know, they couldn't cure anything. If you got sick and you went to the hospital, they just thought you were they thought every human was a sack of God juice. And if you got hurt, God wanted his juice back. And they said a prayer. That's all they did for you. So back then, it was like you weren't taking many years. Now you're taking 50 years from a person's life. Back then, if you lived to 25, they made you mayor. All right? It was not a big thing, but we're still in this. Yeah, oh, an eye for an eye, right? People tell you that. An eye for an eye. An eye for an eye. Here's the thing. That is not how our legal system is set up. For anything else, we don't steal from thieves. We don't sentence rapists to be raped. It's just not that I wouldn't want to see that, but it's not the way our system's set up. We don't even do an eye for an eye in the case of someone stealing an eye. That's not even the, you would think if there was one thing that we did an eye for an eye for, it would be eye theft. But nope. And then the number one, I couldn't tell what the drunk guy was yelling. Well, I'm not sure if you were informed. That's not up to me. That's not. Hold on, let me give him a call. This guy's like, fuck this, why isn't this comedian drafted Bernie yet? In that we have more money than you could ever fucking imagine, alright? Money is nothing to us. Donald Trump just gave Saudi Arabia $450 billion in weapons over the next 10 years, which is enough to end world hunger for fucking 15 years, okay? We have way too much money. We have plenty of money. And I love when they say, oh, we don't have the money to build up our infrastructure, like bridges and shit. We have 66,000 structural deficit bridges in this country. We don't have the money to fix them. Really? But you have the money for the largest surveillance infrastructure ever created. Ever. To watch every one of our citizens. And then we say, hey, I know where we can maybe get the money. Let's tax the incredibly rich. Let's make corporations actually pay their taxes. As opposed to Google paying like 4% because they're based in Ireland. Like, and every time you do that, they go, that's class war. That's class warfare. No, we've been in the middle of a class war for the past 40 years, perpetrated by the top 10% sucking the wealth and the resources to a tiny number of individuals. We're in the middle of a class war, and so I think we actually need class war on the reverse side. The non-violent kind. We need the non-violent kind of class war because you gotta throw pitchforks in the violent kind. It's like a shoulder thing. I don't do well. It's like a throbbing in there. And plus, then you gotta get pitchforks. And where the fuck do you get a pitchfork nowadays? Then you gotta go to some weird store and buy a pitchfork. Then they see there's a run on pitchforks, so they fucking jack the price of the pitchforks up. Then you're pulling pitchfork. Revolution over. You know? Nice cops. Standing between the citizens that live there, the ones they've sworn to protect, and an inanimate object, a pipeline behind them, literally fucking protecting a corporate inanimate object over the citizens they fucking work for. That shows you when corporations take over the levers of the state, that's what it looks like, all right? They are there to protect corporate interests. They're there to protect the wealth of the incredibly powerful. And And you know, if you still don't think we have enough money to do all these things, and like I said earlier, it would take $30 billion to end world hunger for the year. That's the UN's estimate, $30 billion. $30 billion. The Koch brothers could do it three times over. Why? Here's the thing, if we did that, we would fucking be the safest country in the world. Nobody's gonna bomb the country that ended world hunger. You're not getting 72 versions for that. You'd be lucky to get a baker's dozen versions that are kind of half into it, you know? They're like, I guess we're gonna have sex. I don't know, I gotta go in a minute. Really, instead we're just leaving it for Bono to take care of. But if you still don't believe we have no money to do all this shit, when the financial crisis happened, 2008 financial crisis, the Federal Reserve invented $1 trillion to keep the whole thing humming along, to keep the rich incredibly rich, the banks incredibly big. Just invented. Would you play chess with a guy who every time he was losing just put a few more of his pieces on the board? You're like, God, this guy's fucking good. I don't know what he's doing, but no, you flip over the fucking board and then click the little clock as a final fuck you. But yeah, we live in crazy times. I don't know how much time, speaking of times, I don't know how much time I have.
Are
you doing all right?
Gone.
9:07, all right. I'll do a few more minutes. I'm going to jump around real quick because I want to get everything, but technology could actually save us if we take it out of the hands of the corporate state, all right? We need more open source, more encryption, more, we need all take it outside the purview of fucking corporations, and then we'll use it for real shit. Instead, we're using it for like, you know, nonsense, you know, to send dick pics to each other and an emoji here and there. My friend told me he had a smart umbrella. The umbrella, you heard this? The umbrella predicts the weather and texts him and tells him to bring it with him. I don't know if it talks. I don't know if it likes bring me with him. But here's the thing. You have an umbrella that is predicting the weather, protecting you from the weather, and telling you to bring it with you. You're the dumb one in that relationship. Alright, you are just a chimpanzee. You are a fleshy Uber that the umbrella uses to get around town wherever it wants to go. Bikini ad outside, alright? I'll go back to holding a newspaper over my head. I don't give a shit. Get your act together, lying. And all these things can be hacked and fucking observed. I love, you know, and here's the thing. When you it used to be when you say that, people are like, ah, you're a little crazy, aren't you? But it's been leaked documents that have shown the CIA is hacking smart TVs, and they can listen in to everything you're fucking doing. To everything you're doing. And for those of you, and then people are like, I mean, maybe not people in this room, but a lot of people when you tell them about this, they're like, I'm not doing anything wrong, so it doesn't matter. Yeah, tell that to like Aaron Swartz or like Edward Snowden or like they're not doing anything wrong. But it used to be when someone would tell you, hey man, my umbrella is listening to us. You would slowly back off of the elevator, no matter what floor you were on. And now when someone says, hey man, my umbrella is listening to us, a lot of people go, well, stop saying important stuff in front of your umbrella. Easy solution. If you want to have sex, do it in the closet. It should change the way we live. It should change the way we behave. Because we should be appreciating right now, appreciating our shared humanity, rather than giving a fuck about our texts or our tweets, the cash in our wallets, or the rash in our balls, you know? I mean, maybe worry about the rash, but we should be focusing on what really matters. But the reason I think we can't seem to do that is because of our ego as a species. We all think we're so fucking special, says the guy on stage begging you to love him. their butts. But in reality, we are a little bit of fungus on a rock, floating in the middle of infinite space. And if we can appreciate that we're nothing, then I think we could live like we actually matter. Thank you guys so much.